So if you look overall, you have performance of the part, you have the can you achieve a fine tolerance, and prototyping, like custom CNC machine parts, you achieve both of those, okay, but the price is very, very high with traditional manufacturing methods on prototypes. Then you have 3D prints. They don't meet the same performance level. They don't meet the fine tolerances as off-the-shelf designs traditionally manufactured at scale, commodities, okay? But this is the affordable one. This is the expensive one, and this is also affordable, but we just don't have the performance and the fine tolerance. This is what you do. In a design, there's only gonna be a couple of regions where you need the fine tolerance. In this case, I need the strength of the brass, and I need the very fine tolerance geometry of the thread so that I can thread in my screw. So I borrow those properties from the brass threaded inserts. In this case, it was the spring steel, and it's modulus of elasticity and the accuracy of the diameter on those fingers. I borrow it from the spring commodity component. In this case, I need to borrow air tightness, and I need to have 250 PSI of pressure that I can withstand, and airtight, watertight. So I borrow that from an off-the-shelf commodity. I come over here, I need roundness. I need to have this within a fraction of a millimeter roundness so that I can have my dynamic design as desired. Okay, borrowed from a steel ball bearing. Now in this case, I wanna have a friction type of hinge that doesn't swing on its own, that holds its place. I have roundness that I'm borrowing from this HDPE tube. I have compressibility. I have chemical resistance. This is going to last a long time, and it's very strong. Okay, and this is 1% of a tube that comes in a 10 meter length. In this case, I need strength, so I borrowed that from these long steel screws. In this case, I need the fine tolerance of these steel balls, aluminum cast and machined components to have an adjustable camera mount. Borrow the whole set of features here. Commodity, again, now I need to hold the camera arm, camera at a distance that's adjustable, and have the rigidity and the strength of this steel so that it holds it steady even when it's extended. So I borrow those. Then, oh yeah, like these precise threads again, plus even these little features that were engineered in here, a rubber ring that adds friction so it doesn't come loose if you shake it. Then we can come all the way to a design where you're borrowing an entire electromechanical assembly and it's software. And we simply use a 3D print to get this connected to our extrusions, and all of that value and thousands of hours of engineering simply achieved with 3D printing. Don't re-engineer a whole system. You take your design that you have desired, and then you borrow the performance of the off-the-shelf parts. You borrow their fine tolerances, and you borrow their low cost. All that engineering spread out across thousands or millions of units makes it very affordable. And you only design the very, very elements that you need that's unique to your system. If we do these things, we can begin to make hardware the way software has been for the last 20 years, rapidly evolving in the industry, modular, meaning you can hack it apart and you can serve a completely different purpose by grabbing pieces of those and just using the component, the elements that you need. It can be duplicated for free completely across the world. It can be, we are gonna give purpose to having the open source element of our hardware because of all of the above, the way we're making it modular and copyable and useful and 3D printed, digitally manufactured. This is a word that people don't talk about enough, but digital manufacturing is more than just 3D printing. And we'll talk about the definition in another video, but the way things are going, there's been a massive change that just allows this to happen all now for the first time. And that is that these components that we buy now, they're beginning to come with their own CAD models, often parametric, meaning that just like software, you can take it, you can crack it open, and you can say, all right, well, actually, I purchased or I'm cutting it down to this long. I'm gonna have this part of my code execute instead of all of it, or I'm gonna change the color of it. You take that CAD model and on the design side, it's really software. And now we can start making incredible advances in hardware across the world. Let's recap on this. We're gonna update our design mindset on how we design systems. We're gonna transfer the fine tolerances to off-the-shelf commodities. Then we're gonna eliminate the entire manufacturing engineering overhead from custom designs. Then we're gonna commoditize custom engineering designs, because what do I have in my hand? It's a business card and a paperclip, two commodities. It doesn't matter what design is on this business card, it's a commodity. And you can change the design any way you want because it's a digital design. Digital design with a standardized process like 3D printing is a commodity. Then we save trillions.